I just snow machined down to the lake about a couple miles from my house. My buddy is coming to hopefully come pick me up in his plane. We're gonna go scout Sovereign Mountains, which is the tallest mountain in the Talkeetnas. I think it's 8,800, give or take. It might be a couple hundred feet off on that, but just shy of 9,000 feet. Thinking about maybe trying to do a ski descent off of it, and we're gonna try and look for the line and then look for access, whether or not it's gonna be best to land on the Talkeetna Glacier right beside it and go from there, or snow machine up. Ever since I made it all the way up to Sheep Glacier, whenever I was on the timber sled, kind of piqued my interest into maybe seeing if I could make it all the way back to get to Sovereign Mountain. So I ended up texting my buddy and asking him if he could scout the route for me, because I knew that he was going to be flying for the day. And long story short, he ended up just picking me up at the lake a couple miles from the cabin, which ended up being really nice, and going to take a look at the mountain. I've been looking at it on Google Earth. I couldn't really find any photos of the aspect I was looking for, and I wanted to see if it was still realistic to ski off of it. Sometimes Google Earth is kind of hard to gauge things, so that was what we were going after. We could see several pretty promising lines from the top, but my buddy decided to go ahead and make a landing on the glacier to take a closer look. We saw a spot high on the Talkeetna Glacier that looked like a good place to set it down, so we went around for approach and made a landing.
Because I'm trying to go every day, it's nice anyway. And I think if we took a whole day snow machining, I'd feel a bit like, I was like, ah.
Yeah, we wasted it. Yeah, not. I mean, the plane idea was my thought with, or sorry, the snow machine was my idea before I had the access to the plane. On the return flight, we scouted some more opportunities to do future ski missions before he dropped me back off to the lake, so that I could head back to the cabin. It's been about 3 days since we went in and scouted it, and I think today's the day to take the ski gear in and go make it happen.
Well, we're gonna be taking off here in a little bit. Got everything loaded up and gonna have some fun.
Setting off.
Trying to get in the ridge and up there.
Fortunately, the bottom half was easy skinning before transitioning to the booting.
Never thought I'd be going the whole way without gloves and a light layer, you know?
That's so awesome.
A little bit of booting left, huh? Not bad.
A little bit.
I know, right? I'll probably put on over there just so I don't drop a ski, try and get it on or something.
Top of Sovereign. This is gonna be our descent. We're gonna ski right down. All the way down to the little plane. Yeah. Well, we're gonna ski from here. Not there, but we're gonna count it.
A little scratchy, eh?
Getting a little softer.
Okay. Hopefully it gets better as it go down.
Sick.
There it is.
Oh!
Nice. Well, I got a little
slough
going.
Someone's kind of getting soft.
Yeah. Yeah, I think it'll get better down here, I'm hoping. Yeah, I was hoping they're gonna turn this way. Yeah.
Yeah, Forrest.
Make a run for the bottom from here if you want it.
Huh?
I said you can make a run from here to the bottom if you want it.
Yeah. Get it. Yeah, dude. Ooh, straight line from there. Ripping. Right back to the plane.
Oh, man.
Perfect. Perfect day.
Straight lined it further than I realized.
Yeah.
Anytime I can just make turns, you know.
Totally. Yeah, it's better than safety skiing it, but it definitely was like, it wasn't a ripper turns condition. Yeah, I left a little after 12 and it's 2:20 now, so barely, I'd say right at 2.5 hours top to bottom.
Pretty damn good.
Not bad. Plane to plane, 2.5 hours. It's kind of nice that we could skin, you know, 2/3 of it.
Yeah, a bunch of it.
We both skied a line pretty conservatively overall. We didn't want to take a tumble down over any rocks, but since also my buddy was the only pilot, he didn't want to do anything that would jeopardize his ability to fly us out of there. Since it ended up being such a beautiful day, we decided to gas the plane back up and head out for a little bit more of some scouting missions, as well as kind of doing some cool flying over Lake George and Colony Glacier. pretty mind-blowing how much ice is out there. It was a cool way to cap off an already pretty awesome day, and just kind of one more reminder of how spoiled we are to be able to live in a place like this and have these opportunities.